there's lots of moments, I think, in the grieving process, and you still have them. You're just like, a song will come on and I'll just, you know, have tears for no, you know. Usually after most exams, I will have a meltdown where I'll just cry because it's just like, I've just got to let it all out.
Oh, you could pick it from her voice often. And she's pretty open and says, oh, this is getting too much. Or I've had a bad day and, you know, I've burst into tears. And I just tell her to get on with it. Very sympathetic.
Since Jamie passed away, there's one song that I just put on when it gets really bad. Yeah, and I just play it. It's called Fight Song, Rachel Patton. And I just listen to that over and over and over again.
It's been a long journey for single mother of seven, Jo Byrne. 4 years ago, she was working as a florist, a job she'd done for 16 years. But when one of her sons got into trouble with the police, she decided to try her hand at law.
One just wants their problem fixed. It's just not with flowers anymore, it's just with the law. It doesn't smell as pretty either, let me tell you.
This month, Jo will graduate with honours, and she's just started work at a large corporate law firm. And to top it off, she was recently named National Indigenous Law Student of the Year.
She is definitely a type AAA and quite an exceptional person.
Andy Gibson has taught Jo since the start.
She's up at 6 o'clock in the morning doing study, helping get the kids ready for school.
Mum, can you have some cereal, please?
Yeah. Can I just finish this paragraph?
No.
Please. And someone will want a drink, Ben will want cereal, one of the kids will want you to get up and do something. Ben, you're going to have to stop the game. Just stop till we finish this, okay? A lot of my good study time is when the kids go to bed. Quite a few times I'll pull on Friday nights or Saturday nights, like all-nighters.
I'm always really keen. If a student's prepared to learn, then I'm always prepared to help them as much as possible to get through and achieve their dream.
But for Jo, achieving her dream was going to be harder than she ever imagined. When she started studying, she was living with her husband Jamie and the family in Coffs Harbour on the New South Wales north coast.
Jamie was like very supportive. He would take the kids out bike riding on the weekends. The bigger kids would go and do their own thing, so I was able to study on the weekends.
But less than 12 months into her degree, this arrangement came to an abrupt end.
Very early into the session, her husband died suddenly in Coffs Harbour Hospital. During the night when he was admitted, he died. And that's how Jo finished up with seven kids on her own.
It was a very big shock for everyone. Very hard time. While I like kind of coped, I don't think I actually thought about anything. I just focused on study.
We thought that she should take a leave of absence so she can get herself organised and get over the loss of her husband and help the kids. And she felt that she should continue her studies and that she would manage to somehow get through.
Andy would ring every couple of days or send an email, how are you going? Just checking up to make sure I was still, you know, coping.
It was actually at the end of the session that she really started to notice that, you know, her husband was no longer there and things had changed.
Jo had spent most of her life in Coffs Harbour, but as the reality of her husband's death set in, she made a dramatic move. She decided to get as far away from Coffs as possible.
There was five kids, myself and the cat and the dog. Each child was allowed one plastic tub of clothes. Yeah, loaded the actual trailer up with motorbikes and all these tubs and put a big tarp over it and then headed off. One kid's got this music playing and the other one's trying to listen to their music and then others are trying to watch movies and yeah, combined in a little car. For 5 days, pretty much.
She'd never been to Perth, So this was doing it cold turkey. It was a good move because it broke the COFS link between what had happened and where her future could be.
We made it, yes, got here. In the end, we made it.
So, you know, if there's ever an issue arises, you need to look at the relevant act.
Yeah. Jo has just started working as a law graduate in downtown Perth.
We're a large independent WA law firm and we've got lots of practice areas. So she'll get a really good experience and a real breadth of experience in the law before she decides where she'd like to specialise.
This is the first step in what's likely to be a long legal career. But Jo hasn't forgotten why she took up law in the first place.
What I want to do with my law degree is help people who can't have access to the law. There's a lot of people who can't, you know, they have a problem but they can't afford some of the high costs of solicitors, but they don't qualify for legal aid at the same time.
When you look at Jo's personal situation and what she's, the challenges she's had to overcome, it's just remarkable that she's managed to do what she's, I can't express that enough.